So we were brainstorming what to create, and I was like, well, what I kept coming up with was actually just literal representations of what the images were. And so I wanted to leave a little bit of space for how to interpret or abstract the images a little bit more for our creative process and for our final product. So that led us to Dave Yarwood. And I asked Dave, who created the music for our video, to look at the videos, or to look at the pictures, I'm sorry, and come up with a 1 minute sound composition based off of his interpretations of the images. And so we actually started with his interpretation musically of the images. And then from his music, Jen and I were then able to create what we created. So it was an abstract of an abstract to then come together and create our final product.
Interesting. Yeah, I love that connection with the musical composition.
Yeah, you know, well, he's very image-based when he works with his sound scores, and we're very musical when it comes to our images that we make. So it worked out really well, and I don't think I've ever worked that way before, and it was really fun. And yeah, what we found, you know, the mutterings, he just saw a lot of this like moodiness to it. But also the photos depicted only duets and trios. There was one trio, but then four duets. And so this idea of relationship, but then relationship with the self. So he saw a lot of the like mutterings that you say to yourself throughout the day. Mm. And then from that, Jen and I started talking, and we were only getting clips of what we were hearing in the sound score. And we decided to play with then just showing parts of the movement captured on the camera. And what was interesting is as we were filming it, I started to play with floor work and flipping my front, and she just automatically and instinctually started playing with the front view of the camera. And so the whole thing really just started to take shape in the process of making it, which is, you know, this idea of perception. And then whenever she started to edit the film together, she turned it into this cartoon, which is just this other way to distort perception a bit more. And so that's how the process kind of unfolded before us as we were making this really fun project.
That's awesome. What was the most challenging part of this project?
I think the most challenging part for me, I think, was the beginning when I was trying to figure out a way to create something from the images in a way that felt like I had authorship over what I like my personal style or aesthetic. And I think the reason why it was challenging is because I don't know if I've ever really done that before. And so it was exciting to have the opportunity to try to work in that way and to also reflect on why I was getting so stuck in a narrative. And that was really interesting for me, just to like pinpoint what I was stuck in or what I was holding on to. And then just to try to figure out a way to like find a unique entryway into it. And frankly, relying on the collaborators that I worked with. And I think that's the hardest part about just solo work in general. And, you know, during these times, I'm finding a lot of the work that we're doing is solo work by necessity, is that you don't really have that feedback from other people. And so that creative feedback, and then with the partnering, of course, with the other artists, was another layer of feedback that just I really missed. It was nice. Mm-hmm.